In this video, we'll be going through the most commonly used tools for animation in the Tools panel. The Selection tool is used to select anything on the timeline. You can also use it to select, drag, or bend lines and fills. The Sub-Selection tool is useful for editing vectors and vector lines. This will also let you see the vector points in a selected piece of artwork. The Transformation tool lets you edit a selection. When you select something with it, it will give you a bounding box with a pivot point in the middle. You can also skew, rotate, and scale your selection. If your selection is raw artwork made up of lines or fills, you can also use the distort or envelope settings while transforming a selection. In this right-click menu, you will also find break apart, distribute to layers, distribute to keyframes, swap symbol, duplicate symbol, and convert to symbol. The lasso tool lets you draw a freeform selection. If you click and hold on the lasso tool, you'll find that the polygon tool and the magic wand tool are hidden beneath it. The polygon tool lets you draw a selection with a series of straight lines. The magic wand tool lets you select sections of a bitmap that are a similar color. If you click and hold on the pen tool button, more tools will drop down. The delete anchor point tool lets you remove anchor points from your vectors. This is handy for simplifying lines and fills. The line tool lets you draw straight lines. There are lots of line and style settings that you can adjust. You can also create your own line styles. If you'd like to know more about this, you can check out my video on line styles and airbrushes. The rectangle, oval, and polystar tool lets you draw shapes. The pencil tool lets you draw vector lines. You can adjust the style options and smoothing in the properties panel. There are also settings for straight, smooth, and ink styles at the bottom of the tools panel. The airbrush tool also lets you draw vector lines. There are a few additional settings that are different from the line tool. It also lets you draw lines that are automatically converted to fills and lets you apply pressure sensitivity and tilt sensitivity. The brush tool lets you draw fills. There is pressure and tilt sensitivity options, and in the properties panel you can also adjust the size, shape, color, if your brush zooms with the stage, and the amount of smoothing on the brush. The paint bucket tool will let you add color fills to art. Also, at the bottom of the tools panel, there are settings for closing gaps of various sizes when adding fills. The area you wish to fill needs to be in a closed shape. The ink bottle tool lets you add vector outlines to fills. You can also use it to change the appearance of vector lines. If you select a vector line with the eyedropper tool, you can then use the ink bottle tool to change the other lines to match it. The eyedropper tool lets you select the line color and style or the fill color from the artwork on the stage. The eraser lets you erase artwork on the stage. At the bottom of the tool panel, there are settings for erase normal, erase fills, erase lines, erase selected fills, and erase inside. There are also size and shape settings for the eraser tool. The faucet button to the right of the eraser tool lets you erase everything that's connected to the artwork that you click on. The hand tool lets you pan around the stage. If you click and hold on the hand tool button, the rotate canvas tool appears. If you need to reset the canvas after rotating, you can select View, Magnification, Center Stage. There's also a button for this near the zoom display. The zoom tool lets you zoom in and out on the canvas. The line and fill color selectors let you choose colors. When you click on them and it brings up the menu, you can pick colors from within the panel. With this panel open, an eyedropper tool automatically appears. It can select colors from outside the panel or even outside of Animate. That's it for the tools panel. If you have any comments, questions, or tutorial requests, please let me know in the comments. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.